Praise God, praise God. I had got off and then the Lord was talking to me again. I'm telling you guys, you know when I go back to back what time it is, right? I feel the power of God all over me. Praise God, praise God. So, excuse me, if you see my title, it says, "Learn to forgive others. You must forgive others and learn how to forgive yourselves." God would not let me go to sleep without saying this tonight. Body of Christ, people of God, you know, like I said, and I know y'all get tired of me saying it, but I said on purpose, I wasn't always who I am today. But one of the greatest things that I had to get over was my past, what I allowed myself to go through, and what I have done others. I had to really ask God for forgiveness. I mean, it was a year. And I remember that a whole year after God had told me who I was, and I'm functioning as a prophetess at that time, still a prophet, you know, just apostolic leader now. And one of the things I had a hard time with, God cannot call me. I've been too dirty. I've done this, I've done that. And then people, they love to remind you of who you did, what you did, and who you was. Don't I like y'all to know what I'm saying? It could be family, friends, even people that you had a relationship with, even school teachers. It could be anybody, right? And I did a lot when I was young, trust me. If I'd have known that I would have to tell it all or go through it, I wouldn't have done all that, right? I'm sure some of you can attest to what I'm saying here, but stay with me. My whole point was, it was a whole year that God had to mentally renew my mind and in the spirit as well. I had to get in the word because I kept looking at myself as the old person. And God said, "Deanna, you're not going to be able to do this if you keep looking backwards." He said, "I've redeemed you. I've cleaned you." And no, listen to me very carefully. I don't care how pure you think you are, or how great you get, or if you know that Bible up and down, you fast, you holy, you're pure, you will always be flesh, meaning that you can make a mistake, you can do this. He says, so learn now to forgive others of everything that they've done and really mean it, and also forgive yourself. That is what the body of Christ is suffering from right now. And that is a process. I had to forgive the people who molested me. I have to forgive the people that my ex-husband who tried to kill me. I had to forgive a lot of stuff. But now hold on. You know, we're not all squeaky clean. So you also have to also allow others to forgive you as well. And if they don't, that's fine. But long as you have made an effort, I think in the body of Christ, you know, that we talk about church hurt. I even have a book out, Church Hurt. Let me tell you something. It's not just church hurt. It's you did me this and I will not accept it. We have to go back to forgiveness, people. How can God use you if you got bitterness, hatred, ugliness in your heart? And to be honest with you, if you really want to know the truth, and I love everybody, hear me clearly. This ain't no game for me because I'm going to heaven. You could better believe that. Hallelujah to his name. So that means that you have to empty yourself every night before you go to bed. God, I repent. God, I pray that this, and if you have errored anyone or did anybody harm, you're supposed to go to that person. But I'm staying focused on the point tonight. The point is, most people hold grudges. Y'all, I mean, let me tell you something. I'm from Louisiana, and anybody know people from Louisiana, y'all already know how they roll. Now, I think people are the same everywhere, but more so in some places. I have to say it. People in Louisiana, they don't forgive. Y'all ain't ready for me. I'm talking about they hold on that 20, 30 years. I ain't forgiving. I ain't doing devil. If the person can be dead, I ain't forgive. Are you serious? You mean to tell me, hold on. I need y'all to understand me tonight, why God put me back on this live. That stuff will kill you, man, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus. Bitterness, hatred, ugliness, having an ugly heart, that's not God. It will frustrate you. It will stress you, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That stuff add bodily aches. Y'all don't understand. Sickness, disease, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus. That's a spirit, you guys. Because guess what? It's a byproduct of other spirits. When you have unforgiveness, you have hatred. You have strife. You have so many other spirits. Remember something. We're talking about spiritual warfare also here. One spirit is never alone. Just like the spirit of God of peace, love, joy, meekness. You see how they have different, that's also, believe it or not, but that's good spirits, right? Well, guess what? There is not just one spirit. Just like if you have a spirit of greed, gluttony, selfishness, pride, everything works together. So when you are unforgiving, you are working with a whole lot of other spirits. As a matter of fact, you are allowing more spirits to come and to torment you now. And now this is what I'm talking about, torment. As soon as they come in the room, people know you have a problem with them because your face start turning to the left with your mad self. Y'all ain't ready for me. Or you say, oh, I can't. You know how people talk under their breath. And then y'all will pass that spirit on to somebody else because I don't like them. So y'all will try to get everybody else not to like them. Am I talking up in here? Come on, somebody. Y'all know what I'm saying. Now, you can't really get blessed because even the Bible says that if you have aught against your brother, before you even bring a gift to you go and repent and go make, make it better. You know what I'm saying? Make amends. That's what I'm saying. Hallelujah. So I'm telling you, you got to learn how to forgive and forget. I know I'm a forgive, but I never forget. Yeah, with your mad self. And guess what? Now you're wondering why you're going through with your body or even your finances or even your spiritual life. How in the world can you truly serve God in spirit and in truth when you're holding something against your brother and your sister? Because we all have fallen short of the glory of God. And truth be told, we weren't always perfect. And truth be told, we're still not perfect. We're not going to do everything right all the time. That's just not in this flesh. I'm sorry. It's a mess. So you have to forgive others and you have to forgive yourself because both of those are tormenting spirits. What do I mean by that? They replay that thing over and over. A blah, 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 blah. I don't even want to speak that stuff, but y'all know it'll keep you up at night. It'll make you so mad. As a matter of fact, let's go here. Why do y'all think people are killing each other quicker than before? Because that spirit of hate and rage, that starts from unforgiveness. And then the plot starts and the devil just whispers, you ought to kill, you ought to kill, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus. That's what happens. You open the door to one spirit and he said, come on in. Let's go ahead, steal, kill, and destroy. This stuff is real. This is not a game. It's not just a lie. I'm preaching and teaching keys to the kingdom because we got to go back to the oracles of God. This is no more just entertainment preaching and PayPal. I can't stand that. That's why I talk about it. And whatever I can't stand, that means that's in my spirit. So God must have put it there. When we gonna go back to teaching people how to stand, how to be strong, what's wrong, what we need to do to make it better for everybody? Because let me tell you something. Do y'all ever looked at that movie Drumline when they say one band, one sound? Can I tell y'all something? When I hear that, I think one Lord, one body. But that's not really real right now, right? Because guess what? The things that I have had to endure by the hands of my brothers and sisters, it was not street people. It was not sinners. It was men and women of God. That should not be. That should not be my brother. That should not be my sister. And I know we can't change other people, but if you got to be the change that you want to see. And that's what I have decreed and declared to do with my life. That's why I get up on here. That's why I do what I do. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I'm one of the few preachers and I'm gone here. Yes, we all need money, but y'all know I don't be begging y'all because I'm not going to do that. My heart is really for God's people. Period in the story. Y'all bless, y'all bless. You don't. I still love you. I'm still supposed to preach. I'm still supposed to teach. Y'all ain't ready for me tonight. People have made it about money and this. And I heard a preacher say the other day, and it really bothered me afterward because, you know, we replay things, right? So I replayed that whole message, and he was talking about that you must don't like him if you give a little bit of money, but if you love him, you give a lot. That's not of God. Man, I don't know what kind of preaching that was. When I really, now at first, it sounded good. I'll be honest with you. But when I went back and I replayed that, I said, wait a minute, that didn't sound too good. Because what if a person don't have it? So you mean to tell me they don't like you? The devil is a liar. Hallelujah to his name. I just pray that y'all are listening to me for real. And you hear the spirit of God talking through me, because that's is what it's all about. It's not about Apostle Deanna. They said, I'm not that great. I just want to be used by God, whatever God tells me to tell you. And I pray that it resonate in your spirit and that you go tell others and that you live it, you talk it, you breathe it, you preach it, and most of all, you receive it. Hallelujah to his name. This is not a game. We have short time. So many people playing and straying and people dying without God, dying without Jesus Christ. When we going to be about souls? Everybody bought a car and this and I want to be branded and whatever, whatever, whatever. Have you done your assignment? Have you truly witnessed? Are you truly a witness of Jesus Christ of Nazareth? Have you forgiven everybody that did you wrong? I'm asking y'all tonight. I'm challenging y'all. You ain't got to tell me. It's time to release people. And most of all, forgive yourself. Be better. Do better. Come on, somebody. When we did wrong, we were wrong. But the Bible says, train up a child. And when they get old, they will not depart. That's the same way in the spirit. When you were younger in the spirit, you can do them little la-la games. I call them la-la demons. But as you get older in the spirit, repent, make that thing right. Don't have the spirit of pride. And understand that when you stand before your Father in heaven, and you will, you're going to have to give account to everything you said and didn't say, everything you did and didn't do. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. I know some of you don't like this preaching and teaching. I already understand it because it cuts. Hallelujah. So God bless you. God keep you. As a matter of fact, seven of y'all didn't got off. I know, I understand. But my mandate is one mandate. So God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Got number love for you. Roll out soldiers, for that is who you are. God bless.